Welcome to Minute Maths. In this video we are going to look at ordering decimals. Practice questions are at the end of the video. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Have a look at these two decimal numbers. Which one do you think is the largest? Well, the largest number is actually 1.45. So, even though 1.405 may look larger, it is in fact the smaller one. Let's see how this is worked out. Firstly, always compare the digits from left to right. Both of these digits are equal, so we can move on to the first digit after the decimal. Again, both digits are equal. Moving right again, we can see that 5 is greater than 0, meaning that 1.45 is the larger number. Let's see why this is. Have a look at this number line. 1.45 is halfway between 1.4 and 1.5. 1.405 lies halfway between 1.4 and 1.41. To make sure we compare the numbers correctly, it can help to create a table showing the place values, like this one. Next, input the numbers we are comparing, making sure the decimal points are lined up. From looking at this table, we can see that the units and tenths are equal, but that 1.45 has 5 hundredths, and 1.405 has no hundredths. So, 1.45 is greater than 1.405. It may also help to add zeros into any empty spaces. This doesn't change the number, as any zeros added will be after the decimal point. This may make it easier to compare by looking at the digits after the decimal point. We know that 450 is greater than 405. So 1.45 is the greater number. Often, you may be asked to place decimal numbers in either ascending or descending order. Ascending order means from smallest to largest. Descending order means to go from largest to smallest. Let's have a look at another example. This time we have three decimal numbers to compare and put in descending order. Firstly, let's fill the table in with the numbers we have to order. Next, we can put zeros in the empty spaces. You may be able to recognize the order now that we have added the extra zeros, but let's also compare the digits in each place value. Remember, descending means to go from largest to smallest. So, we are looking for the largest number first. We can see that the digits in the units and tenths are equal. Moving on to the hundredths, we can see that 2.81 has a larger value, meaning this is the largest number. The other two numbers have equal digits in the hundredth column, so we should move on to the thousandths. We can see that 2.803 has a higher value in the thousandths column and is therefore larger than 2.8. We can now place the numbers in descending order from largest to smallest. Have a go at these practice questions and pause the video while you work them out. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more videos.